the ground. Inside me, when the word man said, "Bob, I release about that." We literally laid our body on the ground. Now, what does it mean today? Spiritually, you're still bowing down. Are you still worshiping the white image of Jesus? That's not found in the Bible. Yes, your mothers, your grandmothers, your sisters, your aunts, they beat your sons to worship white image of Jesus. They say, "Tyrone, go to church." "Mama, why I gotta go to church and worship the white man?" "Pow, shut up, go to church." And then we get beat to go worship that white demon. Read the whole verse again.
"But I will put it into the hand of them that afflict thee, which has said to thy soul, bow down, that we may go over. And thou hast laid thy body as the ground, and as the street, to them that went over."
So we as the Israelites must get up. We must get up off the ground. We've been laying on the ground in squalor, in ignorance, in confusion for too long. You're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. Black man, Latino man, you ain't Negroes. You ain't Afro-Americans. You're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. You're the people of Moses. You're the people of Paul and Peter. You're the people of Christ and Solomon. Oh, that's too much for you. Oh, no. I don't want to be that. That's too great. That's too glorious. I like to shuck and jive in my church Sunday morning. That's what you black men and black women like to do. You don't want the truth of the Bible. You want the white image of the beast. That's what you want. That's why when destruction comes, you will have no excuse, because the truth is being laid before you this day. You're the Israelites that went into slavery because you broke the commandments. That's who you are. That's who you be now. Get me Psalms 83. Psalms, the 83rd chapter, and let's start at verse 1. We're going to break the truth down for you step by step.
All right.
Psalms 83, verse 1. You got it for me?
"Keep not thou silence, O God."
So King David said in the spirit, "Keep not thou silence, O God."
"Hold not thy peace."
Hold not thy peace. Come on.
"And be not still, O God. For lo, thy enemies make a tumult."
So God has enemies. The Bible prophesies that the enemies of God would rise up against God. Who are the enemies of God? Let's examine that for a second. Job chapter 9, verse 24. Who are the enemies of God? That's the question right now. We're going to let the Bible speak. Job chapter 9, verse 24, and then we want Revelation 2 and 9.
"The earth is given into the hand of the wicked."
Do you hear what the Bible says? The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. Who is ruling the earth? Is it the Negro in Chicago? No. Is it the Chinese? No. Is it the Arab? No. But is the white man ruling the earth? Oh, hell yeah. Read it again. Come on.
"The earth is given into the hand of the wicked."
The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. Better realize who your enemies are, who the enemies of God are. The Bible says the earth is given into the hand of the wicked, meaning the wicked rule the earth. Who is the ruling nation on the earth? The United States of America. Read it again.
"The earth is given into the hands of the wicked."
So the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. Who's speaking? God. Come on.
"He covered the faces of the judges thereof."
The Most High sent us into slavery and allowed the white man to cover our faces. What does that mean? He covereth the faces of the judges. Who are the judges of the earth? The Israelites. There were 12 tribes. The 12 tribes of you American blacks, you West Indian blacks, you Haitian blacks, you Puerto Rican blacks, you Mexicans, you Dominicans. There were 12 tribes that went into slavery. You make up the Israelites, the nation of Israel, that went into slavery for breaking God's commandments. In slavery, they changed your names. They said, "You know, you ain't Israelites no more. This group over here, you're going to be called Afro-Americans. That's you. This group over here, they're going to be called West Indians. That's them over there. That next group over there, they're going to be called Puerto Ricans. That's them over there. That group down yonder, they're going to be called Haitians. That's the tribe of Levi, by the way." Read it again.
"The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where? And who is he?"
If the Most High did not allow the white man to do that, then where? tempting. Go back to Psalms 83. No, Revelation 2:9, I'm sorry. We were trying to establish the enemies of God. That's what we were doing. Because in church they say God don't got no enemies. Y'all fools. You think everybody on this earth loves God. You foolish people. Revelation 2 verse 9.
I know thy works and the tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich.
For you Israelites, you black men and black women, you're the Israelites. Christ said, I know your poverty and your tribulation, all the hell you caught in captivity. But you are rich. Why are you rich? Because all the promises made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob were given to you. Come on.
I know thy works and the tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
Do you hear what Christ said? Christ said, I know the blasphemy of those who say they are Jews. Christ said, I know the blasphemy of those that say they are Jews and are not. And are not. But are the synagogue of Satan. So this ain't our word. This is the words of Christ. This is the words of Christ. Come on over if y'all got questions. Come on. We here for y'all. Read it again.
I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them